Hey guys, getting ready to do a one room stretch and one room clean here. I'm gonna show you, I've got the furniture moved and everything. I've got everything figured out how it's gonna work. So I'm gonna kind of show a little bit of the stretching and then the cleaning. First, we're gonna look at basically what I'm gonna do. Look at the carpet now and then kind of, I might time lapse it if I stretch it. I'm not exactly sure. I'm kind of pooped out, so it won't be any way but time lapse because nobody wants to watch me work this slow. Let me show you. All right, right here. See, we got some issues here. It was installed in 18. It's a very high quality carpet. Should have made it longer than this. Anyway, that's typical though. We've got some more kind of in this area. And here, I've kind of got the thing in the way, but kind of in here, there's one right along that line. And a few in here. So luckily, this was a pitfall here. It looked like the refrigerator was sitting on top of the carpet, but it turns out it's sitting on some older carpet in there. So anyway, this is gonna get reinforcement all down the basement, all down the attic strip, and then you'll see me stretch it. Right, we are done now. It was really pretty difficult to stretch. Really, really non-responsive to stretching. Luckily, it didn't need a lot. Nothing pulled past here. So we're good with all that. We're all good. The carpet was like, I would describe it as like being, trying to stretch cardboard or something. Canvas, just very, very difficult. All right, we're gonna clean it now. So I'm gonna put the cleaning following this video here. So I'm gonna put away all my toys here and then we'll come back and we're gonna clean this one room. And then that'll be done with this job. All right, everybody's favorite part now. We're gonna do the scrub here. This is a seven. pH is a seven on this, we're neutral. Why we're neutral is because we're not removing a whole bunch of soil at all. So there's no reason to get medieval on carpet that doesn't need you to. So we're just gonna give it a nice friendly clean and we're gonna watch it all here in just real time from point of view. So I've got the multi-brush on it now. I've got the brand new multi-brush pad on it. The one that's blend of cotton and polyester both. So anyway, gonna get started here and take my time. This is all I've got left to do the rest of the day. So we're gonna just spend our time here making this one look really nice and making a decent video out of it. Overkill, basically. Right, we're starting out low. Thank you. All right, cranked her up here to full speed. Kickstand. The couch is on plastic feet, so no special precautions need to be made at all. Plastic doesn't bleed. Varnished wood does. Thank you. All right, I'm predicting not a lot of soil. We're gonna go ahead and buff some fibers out here just to see what we got going on. See if we can get any more. Oh yeah, not dirty at all, hardly. There we go, let's take a look. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, to be about like that. Very, very, very lightly soiled at best. There's the side that didn't get used, and there's the side that did, so not a ton of soil. All right, now we will continue with Operation Overkill. Notice you used to see me all the time putting my my rags or bonnets into a bucket. You don't see that anymore because I use the tank now. So I hit the dump valve and dump and get the bonnet wet. So I get it done in one step. So yeah, we won't need any more than that. Just a little bit to keep the towel lubricated. All right, I guess we'll be here first. Thank you. Very little. All right, guys, thanks for watching. That was Overkill on the one room carpet cleaning. If you have any questions, you can put it in the comment section below and I'll get to it as soon as I see it. That does it for this video. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless.